Revered Swamiji, His Excellency the Rajyapal Ji, Tejaswini Ji, Yediyurappa Ji, the Honorable Chief Minister of Uttarakhand and friends. We have all assembled here for a very solemn occasion to be at a condolence meeting of somebody who's very dear to us is an emotional exercise. But if someone who had a face as smiling as this, and that is the permanent memory of AnanthKumar that we have, the pain itself becomes much larger. He was still very young. He still had to perform some part of his family obligations. At a very young age, he started his public life and his political career. He has risen to be one of the frontline leaders of the country. And there was many years of active public service that awaited him. But destiny, perhaps, had thought otherwise. And this untimely death snatched away somebody who was not merely an MP, a minister, a leader, but almost everyone who dealt with him regarded him as a close friend. I came to know him when he was just new in the ABVP. I was a few years older than him. And around that time, in a year or so, I was moving from the ABVP and the BJP had just been formed. He remained in the ABVP for a considerably long period. And that association, more than 40 years ago, culminated into a close personal relationship, a friendship, more than a political relationship. And I had an opportunity to see those aspects of him which not many people otherwise may have seen. I was in Delhi, he was in Bengaluru. When he came to the BJP, we would meet at our national executive meetings. I remember there was a time when, while practicing law, I used to come to the Karnataka High Court. So I would telephone him in advance a day or two earlier. And as soon as I came back, flew from Delhi at night in a hotel, he would be waiting for me. Until 2 o'clock past midnight, we will be just discussing party affairs, organizational affairs, friends, and what's happening. We would eat together. And then, as he grew in the organization, he became a member of parliament, he came to Delhi. Very soon he became a minister. And for some reason, because that was the association when I used to come to Bangalore, instead of referring to me by name, he used to call me Vakil Sahab. And that was the informality of relationship that he had developed. He would tell me that where are you today taking us for dinner? Every time we had our national executive meetings. So he, Venkaya ji and me, and if somebody else also came across, that informal relationship, friendship, discussing politics, party, national affairs, it continued. He became an inseparable part of the national party. He worked hard. He sacrificed his career, he sacrificed his large part of his personal and family life. And from an ABVP ordinary worker to a office bearer to a BJP general secretary in the state, at one stage state president, All India general secretary of the party, secretary of its parliamentary board, which is the highest position, a minister in two governments, an MP six times, a prabhari of several states as complicated as Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, and several other states. He had become an integral part of our organization's political structure. I have been looking back as to what was the best for him. Was the best position for him that he became an important minister? He was a part of the core team of the party. He was a decision maker of the party. A minister. But I think if there was a single largest contribution for which he will be remembered, he along with Yediyurappa ji, all other senior party leaders, Ishwarappa ji, Sadanand Gowda, Jagdish Shetter, I see a lot of them here, and thousands of others, started working for the BJP in Karnataka when we were considered a party of North India. We had a nominal presence in the state. And then came the late 90s where this team was fully active. Our optimum was to win about 40-45 seats in the assembly, win about 4 MPs. And I remember in 2004 I was the Prabhari of Karnataka and I had at least 2-3 more opportunities to be in the state. He was the state president. And all of us together, the people I have named, Yediyurappa ji would remember, we would meticulously plan out that this is a great opportunity for us to leap forward. And from what was a marginal party, an incidental player, we became the largest single. Let's have alliances wherever they help us. Who should be the candidate? And much was written in the newspapers that some of our leaders, Yediyurappa ji and he, would not see eye to eye. But this was a combination I saw. They would discuss and finally always come with an agreed solution. And when any one of the two would meet me, they would not even take the other man's name. They referred to each other, what is the view of my good friend? So when Yediyurappa ji said good friend, it meant AnanthKumar. When AnanthKumar said good friend, it meant Yediyurappa ji. And they would always come with an agreed solution. And then once we leapfrogged into that situation, there was no looking back. And 2008, we got a majority. Since then, we have been a very large party. We send a very large contingent of members of parliament. Karnataka, we have, and it opened the doors for us for southern parts of India. Getting positions, winning elections, Getting recognition yourself is one thing. But to establish the organization as the center stage of what territory originally was not yours. And I think AnanthKumar ji and this team will be always remembered for that situation.